All right. Mike Colter is best known for playing Marvel superhero Luke Cage, who's famous for his bulletproof skin. Boy, I'd like some of that. Fans may also know him as Lamont Bishop, the Chicago drug lord from The Good Wife and its spinoff, The Good Fight. Now he's taking on a new role in the CBS drama Evil. Colter plays a priest in training who investigates unexplained phenomena for the Catholic Church.
There are people in this world who are connectors. They influence people. They have day jobs, teachers, stockbrokers, expert witnesses. They pretend to be normal, but their real pursuit is evil. Encouraging others to do evil. You don't have to believe in the supernatural to know that there are people out there who do bad things and encourage others to do bad things for the sheer pleasure of it.
Psychopaths.
Yes.
Mike Colter, welcome again. Your co-star, Katja Herbers, in the pilot episode says, I didn't know such a job existed. Yeah. It does actually exist,
yeah.
There are investigators for the Catholic Church, and you met one?
Well, I wouldn't say an investigator. It's more of a guy who dealt with exorcism specifically,
yeah.
Which is sort of one of the job descriptions or one of the things that my character also will deal with.
Did you get some tips?
Oh, I got a lot of tips. Things that I'm shocked. You know, I was talking to him and I really was in awe because it's such a life dedication. I mean, you're talking about a person that basically gives up their personal life to work for the church, and it's a huge undertaking. And
it says in the bio, it says, this creepy new drama at CBS, yeah. Do not watch it alone or with the lights off.
Yes.
And I thought, for people that don't like to be scared, this is not for you. But you said, Anthony, it's a smart psychological,
yes,
thriller.
Yeah, there's an intellectual,
yes,
aspect to the fear. It's not just, yeah, boo.
It's,
yes,
not,
you know,
just scaring you for the sake of scare.
No.
Yes, it makes you scare yourself, is basically.
Uh-huh.
Well, exorcisms are on the rise in this country. I mean, the job that you're playing in the show is actually one that's in demand right now. The Atlantic reported back in December that exorcisms are actually at an all-time high.
Yeah.
Having met somebody to prepare for this role who's actually doing that kind of work, mm-hmm, did it change your thinking on the supernatural?
You know, I like my character, would like to think that I invite a lot of questions. I like to invite, yep, debate. I'm a contrarian by nature. Mm-hmm. So when someone present something to me that I don't agree with, I'm happy to sort of invite,
right,
that and sort of have a conversation about it. So when this, anything that I don't know about, I'm all ears. I'm not a person that shuns people when they start talking about things that I don't agree with. So the whole topic of exorcisms is very interesting to me. You know, the idea that there are demons or that there are people who believe that they're possessed.
Right.
Interesting.
Well, topic. What's interesting too in this drama is that the two people you work with, mm-hmm, don't agree with you.
Both of them are skeptics in a sense, yeah.
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 And so you have to work this out between each other.
Yes, exactly. So I bring them Katja Herbers' character. I bring her character on, and I bring Asif Madvi's character, Ben and Kristen.
Yeah.
They work with me to find the truth, essentially.
Yeah.
That's really what it's about.
It's about science versus religion.
Science versus religion.
And there's disagreement. But you said, listen, we can use this as a way to start conversation.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Which is what we need in this country right,
exactly,
now.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Two diametrically opposed people coming together and agreeing to disagree, but at the same time, being civil.
And, know, respecting each
and
other's
respecting
point of view.
Each other's point of view. And, yeah, it's actually intriguing because that's really what attracts our two characters, our debate, our mental debate, because we're opposites, but we find a very common ground in the sense, yeah, that we are intrigued by each other's intellect.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you played Luke Cage before this, and apparently you put on 30 pounds of muscle to,
yeah,
play him. It's hard to imagine you without that muscle. It looks like you were born with it.
Yeah, I look at pictures now, I go, wow, I don't look so good. You know, it looked like I was ill or something like that. It was something I needed to do for the role, and
I don't think that looks ill.
Before. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I think either or, I think I'm okay, but it's hard to get the weight off now.
It was a first black superhero lead character. Mm-hmm. If it came back, would you come back for it?
I'm always open to discussion. You know, it's amazing. You know, you can ask your next guest Bob and see what he says.
Yeah.
He has more intel than I do.
There you go.
What about bringing you back?
Yeah. Hey.
You can tell him you're available when he passes through the green room.
Not at this very moment, but Bob, at some point, give me my cell phone number. We can talk.
That's all.
You said your favorite villain is actually the Joker.
Mm-hmm.
Why?
Well, it's the idea of the Joker. You know, the idea that every person that plays a Joker has so much fun.
Yeah.
You know, part of villainy attracts people to villainy and makes it easier to play is you have fun. You have, yeah, a broader spectrum, a bigger platform to just have fun. You're not pigeonholed by the idea that you have to do this a certain way.
Yeah.
And that's why the Joker is so appealing, because at the end of the day, he's looking for a laugh,
yeah,
you know?
Well, because you're a member of the CBS family, we are certainly cheering you
on. Thank you so much.
Certainly cheering you on.
Okay, Mike Colter, thank you. Evil premieres Thursday night at 10, 9 Central, right here on CBS. Ooh, look, it looks so ominous, right here on CBS.
Simple and effective.